literacy really helps the students to develop their higher order thinking skills. It helps them to the world and their situation in the world from different points of view. It really helps them to create and define arguments, and it helps them to find evidence to support their ideas and their thinking. So PPC stands for Philosophy for Children, which was a process created by Matthew Lipman in the 1970s. And it's a process whereby children can engage in philosophical dialogue within the classroom. It's not particularly about studying philosophers and which philosophers said what or how philosophers acted, but it's more about engaging in a philosophical dialogue yourself and with other students.
It depends what you mean by belief, because if you're saying, I believe that it is moral to kill someone, like, it's not okay to think that. But if you have a certain religion or belief, it's okay to have that.
When you're born, you don't have like a soul inside you, you have to build your soul up. Like, you're like a sponge soaking in water, soaking in personalities. And when you, I don't know, like maybe there's a point in life where you just complete your soul, and that's, you can't really have a soul for when you're born. You collect things and you explore the world, and then you reach the vaccine. So.
Who evolved you into who you are today? You or the people around you?
Does nature and nurture make you who you are?
You have done both, and there's always plenty of you, but it's really helpful for other people, because the other people make the decisions, but you're the one who actually makes the final decision. So you're the one who makes your choice.
Sometimes our personality, how we show to people, is different than who we are inside. Yes. Have you ever been somewhere where you've acted very confident but you felt very scared inside? So which of those is your personality or your soul? Yes, I was trained in PPC in 2007 and I came to BISB in 2008, and I've been using PPC in my classes ever since. So some of the staff have been trained in PPC as well here at school, and I've done a lot of professional feedback and staff meetings to help develop the understanding and the use of PPC within our school. And we use it as a teaching tool as opposed to a subject within itself, so I use it in history and geography and English, and I've used it in math and science as well. So I use 10 steps in PPC, which is how I was trained with Sapere, and that basically involves some individual thinking time, some small group discussion time, and some whole class discussion time based around a stimulus. So I will have a theme that I want the children to study, and I will find a stimulus that goes with that. The stimulus could be a video or a photograph, a story, a poem, it could be an activity that we do. And then after the stimulus, the children think about it, they discuss it in small groups, and they come up with questions that they want to discuss as a whole class, and then the whole class inquire about that question they've come up with. I'm always surprised by what the children say during PPC sessions. The first time I used it, I was totally amazed at how deeply the children thought. In a regular class, we talk to the children, we teach them, this is what we're doing and this is what we're focusing on, but when we allow them the opportunity to ask their own questions and to start to try and define their own answers, it's really amazing the thought process that they have and the ideas that they come up with.
You foresee there's a wide variety of answers, and you're really free to say what you think, and no one's going to tell you you're wrong, because everyone has a different point of view, and P4C is really about everyone sharing their point of view.
What do you think?
When I think of P4C, I think of my brain running on a treadmill. It really gets you thinking, and you can explore the world, and you can get into topics you've never went in before. What I like is that there's really no wrong answer. You can say what you think, and let's say you start with one question, you can go like 50 miles away from that into a totally new place.
I think P4C has really helped me in school because it helped me connect the dots with what my teachers say to what I've learned before, and that's really helped me, so I really like it.
I like P4C because there's no right or wrong answer, and you can dig as deep as you want in the question. I also like it because you can get confused, and you can come back to it and think a little bit deeper and say, what else is there about this that I can build up onto that question?
So this is the pit of confusion, and so you can learn a lot, but sometimes something bad just happens, and you fall in the pit, and it takes you a very long time to get out. But when you get out, you know a lot more than when you fell into it.
So there have been a lot of studies to show how PPC can positively impact children's learning. But just as a class teacher, I noticed that children write better stories when they use PPC because they can really understand how a character feels. They ask better questions in science because they really understand why they need to know something. They ask better questions in maths as well, and they're much more keen to ensure they've got the correct answer and why they've got the correct answer in maths, because they know how important it is to be able to defend an opinion or to be able to defend something that they've proposed to the group. I know that I'm not alone in thinking that P4C should be used in every classroom around the world, and I'm very excited to be involved in something at this stage when it's just beginning to develop and seep out amongst classrooms and places of education all over.